Yes, good morning. My name is Regiment Sergeant Major Bruce Mayhugh. I am a member of the Coldstream Guards, a regiment which is a living history unit centered in Aurora, Illinois. To my left over here is my youngest and newest member right here. His name is Brent Seitz. He has joined the Coldstream Guards. He does Coldstream Guards in this period and also in the, what do you want to call it, the Napoleonic period. New gentleman. The two soldiers that you see, Mr. Ogle here, Mike Ogle, are wearing 1908 pattern equipment and general service dress. On the shoulders, as in mine right here, you will see a rose and the two letters CG. That stands, of course, for Coldstream Guards. The rose is for the Tudor household of Great Britain. The tent behind you is a what's called a double bell wedge military tent, which was used from the Middle Ages all the way up to current period. The headquarters that you see here, field service desks, chairs, tables, so on and so forth, would have been used, though more commonly, believe it or not, is stripping furniture from houses in the local area. And there are photographs from World War I showing them sitting in lounge chairs in the middle of camp that they had stolen from some neighbor's house. The trench position over here, fighting position, all of the gentlemen here are carrying what is called a smelly, which means short magazine Lee Enfield rifles. It the magazine holds 10 rounds, bolt action. If you are a British soldier, you should be able to fire a total of 55 rounds in 60 seconds. At the Battle of Grumont, when the Germans first attacked in the Mons, the older British regimental soldiers accounted for 11,000 enemy casualties for the loss of 600 dead. Germans don't seem to be able to aim that well, though they have much greater artillery. But the British soldier is taught to aim extremely well.
Hi, Bob.
Hi, Mom.